is the beginning. Watch what you think, they can read your mind. This is the beginning. I got my mug, see it in my eyes. This is the beginning. With my reflection, I don't recognize. This is the beginning. Do you think we can? Rejecting abusive corporatism. It's not about political polls. It's about overseas death tolls. It's not about excess. It's about greed. It's not about tolerating each other against a common enemy. It's about consolidating efforts in a shared future for all people in every country. It's not about the have-nots. It's about the should-haves. It's not about anger and complacency. It's about required common decency. It is about collectively standing up and saying we're mad as hell and we don't have to take this shit anymore. As the borders between nations grow thinner, we fill each other's airwaves and share the internet. We no longer have a faceless enemy. As we look inward and speak with each other, the lies become so much harder to believe because our friends, lovers, sisters, and brothers are the faces we're being lied to about. Occupation is not about borders. It is about the family of humanity. It's about America and every nation in solidarity standing high and saying that we wish to be afforded by ourselves, by our government, and by each other to pursue happiness in the absence of those who wish to hoard resources collected by all for the few. We've been told time and time again that we are unorganized and have no demands which make sense. For future generations that look back now, I would like to state that this fabrication is put forth by media outlets with vested interests in money made by the machine owned by our keepers. Think critically and question everything, because when injustice becomes law, resistance becomes your duty. It's not that we know too little, it's that we know too much. It's not that they discredit us, it's that they are now afraid of us. Thomas Jefferson once said that all tyranny needs to gain a foothold is for people of good conscience to remain silent. And we have been silent too long, and we are silent no more. When I was a young man, I was taught that we are the keepers of our elected. They are set in place to protect our interests and to speak on our behalf. I was told this while corporations and oil barons lined the pockets of the people guarding us while we slept. I was told this as in our name. Our name. Wars were fought on foreign soil while the streets and businesses decayed around our shoulders. I was told this while the civil rights of brothers and sisters were ignored because the rich few who were full of hate were hand in hand with the keepers we trusted to protect our freedom. As Lady Liberty pressed her lips to the poison kiss of the sleepless dream we dreamed, they fed us drugs to let in the nightmare things. We gather on ground not tainted by currency or greed to lay true the stairway to tomorrow, where all people are free to pursue happiness on equal footing. It's not about hate, it's about love. It's not about rage, it's about revolution. It's not about subservience, it's about indentured servitude. But I cannot speak for you, so I ask you to speak for yourself.
Of Smith & Wesson Model 100 double lock handcuffs. Now all you need is a regular bobby pin. You want to peel away the plastic protective covering on the ends of the bobby pin so it'll work right. Now after you've removed the concealed bobby pin, you want to open it up. Put the end of the bobby pin in the keyhole and bend it one way. Then take it out and bend it the other way. Now you should end up with an angle shape that looks just like this. Let me show you a close-up of how the bobby pin actually unlocks the handcuffs. Insert the bobby pin in the keyhole. And on the very edge, you want to take the bobby pin and bend it down. This will release the ratchet, which will open the jaw on the handcuffs. Now, if they've been double locked, you just put the bobby pin in the keyhole on the other side, release the double lock, and then turn it around to release the ratchet and open the jaw. As you can see here, I'm handcuffed in tight, and in about 5 seconds, I've opened up the handcuffs.
At 2:19 p.m., Citibank Action 555 LaGuardia Place, that's an address. Occupiers are inside and currently being arrested. At 2:23 p.m., there's 22 people arrested in Citibank who are trying to close their accounts. 2:43 p.m., 4,000 people in Washington Square, around 3,000 in Liberty Park. 3:26 p.m., General Assembly of Washington Square Park marches on Times Square, around 5,000 strong. 5:30 p.m., thousands of protesters pour into Times Square, 5,000 more from Liberty Park to Times Square on their way. At this point, 15,000 are in Times Square. At 6:22 p.m., police on horseback arrive. Police pulling people out of crowd and attacking them. Protesters are rushing barricades. At 6:45, police have trapped people in Times Square with barricades. At 7:30, unconfirmed estimates ranging as high, ranging from 20,000 people to 50,000 people in Times Square. 8:30 p.m., tensions escalating. Scanner says that riot police are in full gear with batons and the whole works.
3G is off.
And 3G was cut off in the city.
Really?